I want to connect to my colleague Ankit Tyagi, who's joining us live from Hyderabad. You know, Ankit, it's quite interesting because he was to take oath at 1:24 and he came exactly at 1:24. KCR known to plan his political calendar all around astrology and numerology.
Well, his Jyotishi is the most important man, more than the cabinet ministers that he appoints, Preeti, and that is what the Jyotishi told him yesterday at 1:24. He started after the Rahu Kalam from his residence, came here, and we are outside the Raj Bhavan here in Hyderabad. The oath-taking ceremony, of course, KCR had to take oath at 1:24. A lot of supporters here, in fact, standing, massive police arrangements also in place. Interestingly, I saw all the cars that KCR drives or is driven in have the 666 number. So superstition and politicians in KCR is only taking that, in fact, forward. Another interesting aspect about this, Preeti, is that along with him, only one other person is taking oath today. He will expand the cabinet later, and that is Mohammad Ali. He's the former Deputy Chief Minister who is in fact taking oath along with KCR, a very clear sign to his most solid vote bank. That is the minority vote, that is the Muslim vote. And KCR once again making sure that he along with Mohammad Ali takes oath, sends across a message, because this time with Mahakutumi coming in, this whole experiment which failed, the idea of the Congress party was to try and you know, somehow drive the Muslims away from KCR, and that would have dented KCR's political fortunes. Well, unfortunately for the Congress party, that didn't happen. And as we speak, he's once again sending that message, consolidating his, in fact, appeal as far as the minority community is concerned. So there are expectations that more people will be taking oath very soon once KCR finalizes his cabinet. And also the fact remains this time to be seen is what portfolio does his son KTR gets in this cabinet. Is he going to be a deputy chief minister? What sort of an important portfolio is he going to get? Because a lot of people here on the ground are talking about how KCR already is aiming at the center, and he possibly is going to leave the state to his son.
All right, but Ankit, away from, of course, the astrology, the numerology, the fact is, you know, he swept the state of Telangana, limiting Congress to less than 23.
Well, you know, he did not. He swept the state and he decimated the Congress alliance. Chandrababu Naidu, who last time had 13 seats, have been reduced to 3. Congress, which had 33 seats, is down to 17. So basically what he did, this entire alliance, you know, Preeti, it's very interesting. It's not that there was no anger against KCR. There were people, those who were not happy with this government. Though I must say, if traveling around Telangana, you get a sense that largely his schemes are working. Largely people understand what he's trying to do. Few schemes have delivered on the ground, few have not. But largely, there was not a massive anti-incumbency wave against KCR. Apart from that, there is an emotional connect. He's a grassroots level leader who has his emotional connect, known as the father of Telangana. So that sentiment he exploited, and the Congress gave him that opportunity when they aligned with the TDP. TDP, remember, was always painted as a party which was against the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh, which was against Telangana. And with aligning with the TDP, KCR got an opportunity to whip up that pro-Telangana sentiment as far as people are concerned, because mind you, the Congress party and Sonia Gandhi especially, they do enjoy a lot of credibility among the people of Telangana when it comes to the formation of the state. The Congress, with this experiment of Rahul Gandhi of aligning with the TDP, trying to make this big Mahakutumi, the brand alliance, the Congress gave it all on a platter to KCR. The arithmetic was in favor of the Mahakutumi or the grand alliance with percentage of vote, if you calculate that. But the sentiment, the chemistry was for KCR. He was able to whip up the anti-TDP sentiment. He, in fact, went on campaigning, saying that the people, those who did not want all of us to have this state, are now together. And that, I believe, possibly worked in a very, very big way among the voters. So the Congress, by trying to get the arithmetic right, failed to get the sentiment right, because the TDP and Chandrababu Naidu, they have influence among the settlers, from the Andhra settlers, but across the state of Telangana, okay, Chandrababu Naidu doesn't have the kind of appeal that a KCR does, and that is precisely what worked in his favor, and he has swept the state. in fact now aiming at trying to influence elections in Andhra Pradesh. That is going to be a problem for Chandrababu Naidu when it comes to 2019 elections.
All right, you know, Ankit, stay on with me. We're going to come right.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.